puts a lot of work. He puts a lot of work into his network, and if we don't negotiate well with this one, we could be on his next year. Hey, look, it's really terrific because we give the Ford Mondeo away with the blessing of Ford. We said, you know, a week or two ago, look, all you have to do is do this number or SMS, whatever. 82,000 people entered the competition to win the Ford Mondeo. Yes. 82,000. And three finalists are with me here. We have Betty on this side, we have Chris here, and we have Amanda. Let's make them welcome. Are you excited? Well, now, to determine who will win the Ford Mondeo, we lower the golden bucket. Here comes the golden bucket. Now, if you would each like to, at the same time, put your hand in there. There's nothing lethal in there, just three ping pong balls with numbers on it. Just put, this will determine, in they go. Don't have to fight over the ball. There you are. And out with the golden bucket. Thank you. Now, it's not well trained. Betty, you have number on your ping pong ball. You have number?
Seven.
No, it's number one. We'll just double check that. We'll just check that with our for the legal reasons. It's number one. I know it's a rather long stem and it does look like a seven. So, Chris, you are holding
number two.
And you, Amanda?
Number three.
I thought you'd say that. We will now determine who will win the Ford Mondeo. When I click my fingers, we'll all click our fingers on the count of three, the doors will open. One, two, three. The doors are open. When I click my fingers, the doors will close. No, sorry, I'm just mucking around. Just click the fingers, the doors will open again. There they go, two sets of doors opening. And come with me. You will be standing on the spot that is numbered back there and you'll be in front, one of you, will be in front of the Ford Mondeo. Come with me.
Ah, I see.
There we are. Now, you were number seven. You were number one, so Betty, you're there. Chris, you're in the middle. Amanda, you are there. Now, behind the curtain is the Ford Mondeo, and there are two other vehicles alongside us. We don't know who is going to win this. I have a blindfold in my pocket, and I'd ask you to all put your blindfolds on. But first, let's raise the curtain. It's a little get smart, this, isn't it? You know, we've got the doors going back, but the curtain goes up, and the cars are completely covered. Yes. We still don't know, so I'd ask Lavinia and Suze to come in and blindfold our end contestants. If you'd like to put that on, we'll put that on. Chris, Betty, you have your blindfold
you.
On.
Yep.
Amanda and Betty here.
And for the viewers at home, the car is underneath the blue cover. The blue cover.
I'm glad you said that. We are going to now... You are blindfolded. You can't see, any of you can't see. All right, for our viewers at home and our studio audience, let's take the covers off the vehicles.
Okay.
All right, contestants, we'd like you to turn around with blindfolds on. No, with blindfolds on, Betty. There you go, there you go. Now, the person to win the Mondeo, the lovely silver Mondeo, please take your blindfolds off, see who has won the car.
Betty! Betty! You won it!
I won it!
There we are being congratulated by our consolation our runners up, that is, our two runners up. And we're going to ask, we'd like to ask, is it David Cattick coming in from over the wings from Ford who has the keys? David, thank you for coming in and thank you for your support. Come in here, David. That's Betty. She is going to receive the keys from the car from David.
Right, thank you. Well, on behalf of Ford Australia, we're very pleased to present you with this fantastic car. It's got heaps of technology, Bluetooth voice control, and best of all, during the week, Daryl, it's just won the diesel version, just won the car of the year for the mid-size version from Drive.com. So
well done.
It's a great car. You'll be very happy with it.
I am I'm so happy. Thank you very much. Thank you, Ford and Channel 9. I'm so happy. You've looked after me beautifully.
Oh, well, let me give you those.
Our pleasure, Betty. You've got the keys to the car. Don't get in it and drive it off. We might have an accident. I want to bring... can we bring Mark to the window? Oh, you've got something else you want.
One more thing just to add
hang
a little extra touch to the prize. We want to extend the warranty on the vehicle to 5 years.
Five-year warranty on the vehicle. Not that anything's going to go wrong with it anyway. Yeah,
it's a great car.
And look, we're really pleased. Mark Winterbottom has come in, one of our great V8 drivers. Mark, great to have you in.
Thank you for coming in.
Now, Mark's come in not to give Betty lessons. She doesn't need lessons. But our two runners-up, Amanda and Chris, are going to do a hot lap with you, aren't they?
And I'm going to extend your insurances for the next fight.
No, you're not.
You may need to increase them after a hot lap, but they're going to be great. We'll take you for a spin in the car, and you'll enjoy it. It'll be a great ride.
This little number's yours, eh?
Yeah.
Is this yours?
This is my little number, yeah.
Oh, OK. Well, this little number is going to get you around the track in record time. In fact, if you don't believe me, I mean, he's got a whole range of cars, and he was only out yesterday. We filmed this. Someone was in the car with you, and you did this lap. Well, I couldn't believe it when you came down the straight. Look at him. Coming down the straight like this, absolutely incredible. That's how good this man is. Mark, thank you for coming in. Betty, congratulations. David, thank you for your support all over the year. Thank you, Lavinia. Thank you, Suze. Thank you, Amanda. Thank you, Chris. I'm just going to go and say thank you to all of our individual audience members. We're going to go to a break now, and we're coming back up with the most completely different. I'm trying to give away things like that. Absolutely fantastic. I love it. As we play Celebrity Head. One of the very quick thing, that one. One of the most popular segments we've had on the show, and we welcome back Mark Winterbottom driving tomorrow. You're driving tomorrow?
Next weekend,
is it? Well, you're driving tomorrow, but you won't be in a race. You've just got to drive down to the shops, get the milk, the eggs,
I will be. Next weekend, Sydney Telstra 500, so that's our final round of the year.
Final round of the year, how do you think you'll go? Are you primed? You pumped?
I'm third. I'm
you're
a mathematical
third,
chance
in the overall
of winning,
championship.
But
yeah.
If they don't turn up, I'll be right.
Oh, no, don't. You're lowering your standard there. You're a great driver. But you've never been up against Brooke McClymont, have you?
Yeah.
I mean, in a driving thing. Brooke, what's on for you and the girls? Where are you playing?
We're actually playing at the V8s next weekend, so I might be able to see you.
Hey, you might have he might do you a quick hot lap.
Ooh.
Around the track. Or vice versa.
Yes, okay.
You're lucky. And on the end, Steve Izard from MTR Radio in Melbourne. Every day through the week from
10 to 1, Darryl.
From 10 o'clock to 1 o'clock. And we now invite Russell to put celebrities on top of our celebrities. Heads. That's why it's called Celebrity Head. We turn the monitor around so no one can see who they will be. Welcome to look at each other's, of course, but you will not know who you are. All right, and we'll start. We will start with Brooke in the middle. You get the first question.
Okay.
If you get a yes answer, you get another question.
Okay. Am I human?
You are. Let me think.
Really.
Yes, you are human. Yes, Mark. Oh, no, you get another question.
Go.
Yes, sorry.
Am I alive?
Just.
Yes, you are.
Am I an idiot?
Yes.
Oh, no. No, I'm going to say no and move to Mark. I'm going to move to Mark.
Am I youngish?
Youngish? No, you are oldish. Steve.
Have I been in the news lately?
Kind of always. Yeah. Someone said always. I'll give you a yes because you're always in the news, but not particular for a particular thing.
Thank you. Am I someone who would be tweaking a ball occasionally?
You do a lot. I think you are seen to be doing a lot of things in your career, but I don't think tweaking a ball in this sense would give you a yes. I think I'll go to Brooke.
Am I tweaking a ball lately?
I'll give you another one. Mark.
Oh, no. I don't want to say the same question.
No, don't say the same question. No, please don't.
Just in case, am I a male?
No, you are not male. We're back to Steve.
Am I a female?
Yes, yes you are. You're going hot.
Am I a female... I haven't tweaked. Am I a female who would be on the catwalk?
Well, yes, yes. I hope I didn't lead you into that by saying you are often, you're everywhere or whatever, but yes, I'll give you a yes on that.
Am I a swimsuit type female?
Not particularly. I'll give you a maybe or a half, and I'll go to Brooke.
Okay. Am I a sports star?
No, you're not a sports star. Mark?
No.
Am I a sports star?
I think you're a good sport, but you're not necessarily a sports star. Back to Steve. Back to Steve, who's on the catwalk. He sort of... You got warm with that, Steve. I have to give you that. You were getting warm with the catwalk.
Am I Australian?
Yes.
Australian... Am I Jennifer Hawkins?
Yes. I'm amazed. I'm simply amazed. The powers of deduction of that man. See, you could have said Al, you could have said Miranda Kerr, you could have gone at you straight for the hawk.
You threw me on the ball tweaking exercise. Ball, I would have got there earlier.
Yeah. Do we have a prize? Because I didn't mention the fact that... And you were playing for, in our audience...
I'm either playing for Bulleen from Ashley or Ashley from Bulleen.
I think it's more Ashley from Bulleen. There she is, Ashley. And I forgot to mention our other two players, but it doesn't really matter, they didn't win anything. So, John, what sort of prize does Ashley get?
Ashley, for winning celebrity head, you've scored this top-shelf refrigerator, tailor-made for the entertainer and all of us. With a huge capacity, this French door fridge is also perfect for a big family. Valued at $2,299. Runners-up will be taking home the cool top-mount fridge valued at $1,099. They're from Whirlpool.
John's voice is just going to get there to the end of the show, isn't it? Really just hanging into the end of this show, Jono.
Oh, no, Darryl, yes, it's really good now.
Please thank Mark Winterbottom, Brooke McClymont and Steve Izar, the winner on the end. And we'll be back for a big finale after the break.